The UK and Ireland recently received a pretty huge overhaul in Microsoft Flight Simulator. However, the update brought with it a fairly significant bug. Progress also continues on Sim Update 3, although due to the aforementioned bug, the update has been hit with a delay. Meanwhile, we finally get to see Aerosoft CRJ in action. Let's jump in and take a look at all of that. So, anyone who has been flying in a flight simulator lately will almost certainly have noticed a hefty bug that hit how flaps function. In short, this affects the lift when flaps either fully engage or otherwise engage to a large extent. The lift is effectively doubled when this occurs, and this is problematic for a lot of obvious reasons, that is, doubled at what it actually should be. So the problems that this may cause are pretty obvious, not least because it will affect takeoff and landing, but also affect many other maneuvers. It's a problem that will affect all flights and therefore is something that the Sobo are very keen to address. It seems though as though this might not be an especially easy fix, or wasn't a particularly easy fix, as Microsoft have stated it will require extensive testing. Whilst this fix is due to be released this week as a hotfix, it does mean that the additional work has caused a delay for Sim Update 3 as well as World Update 4. Fortunately, the delay is only 1 week, so isn't especially significant. Let's take a look then at the latest roadmap and see where everything is at. Sim Update 3 then is due to arrive in early March. The roadmap currently lists the release date as the 9th of March, although this is listed under the 11th of March entry for some reason on the roadmap there. Sim Update 3 will also bring a huge bunch of changes, additions and improvements to the Garmin G1000 and G3000 systems. This is something that has been long awaited by the community. Though we don't know the full extent of these changes, Asobo have hinted in the past that they want the Garmin systems to have as close as possible to full real-world functionality. The update will also fix the autopilot issues associated with the Garmin systems. There should also be some fixes to live weather and wind readings, which are currently inaccurate in some circumstances. Also, a while ago, simmers started noticing that some objects in Flight Simulator were actually glowing, when in fact they shouldn't be, and this would include things such as aircrafts. Sim Update 3 should be bringing in a fix for this. Beyond that, there's no other news on what Sim Update 3 will contain, but I fully expect, or at least I hope, to see a load of fixes for the sim in general. April will see the arrival of yet another world update. World Update 4 will focus on France and Benelux. As with previous world updates, this means new points of interest for the regions, photogrammetry updates for some cities, as well as train data improvements. World updates usually also contain tours and flight challenges, so there should be plenty to look forward to with that update. Now, April brings us to the end of the current roadmap. Will Asobo continue to release world and sim updates after this? The answer to this does certainly seem to be yes. It's also worth keeping in mind that so far all of these updates have been free and included in the purchase price of the sim. Asobo have said they do want to continue doing that, however they have also said that there will be some paid updates as well. Now personally I wouldn't at all be surprised to see a paid update being announced within the next few months. What this would contain is anyone's guess, but based upon the quality of the current world updates and the world updates we've seen so far, I would imagine that any paid update would be pretty significant. All of this though is pure speculation, so I guess we'll just have to wait and see. Meanwhile, improvements for the terrain visuals, the release for the DirectX 12 update and improved pushback are still on schedule for 2021. In terms of VR, Asobo are working on performance and visual improvements, which should also be arriving later this year, along with some improved VR controls. Now, what improved VR controls actually means, I don't know, but I would assume it would mean the support for touch controllers and similar, and that would be really nice. The ability to directly interact with all the cockpit controls would be a very welcome addition to VR indeed. Elsewhere, YouTuber TheDude got hands-on experience with Aerosoft's highly anticipated CRJ. The CRJ is likely to be among the most detailed planes so far released for Microsoft Flight Simulator, both in terms of its visuals as well as its functionality. The video from TheDude is a tutorial that walks through the safety checks for the CRJ, which means we get a good view of the cockpit. In follow-up videos, the plan will be to go through a full flight. Now, if you're interested in checking out the video for that, do take a look at the link in the video description. That then brings us to an end of this video. As always, thanks for watching, and I'll catch you guys and girls next time.